right, you don't want to go to the subatomic level just yet, so let's continue. If you're starting from this video, you should know that this is video part 2. Go back and watch part 1 first. Moving forward from here, we need to save our sketch and exit the sketching mode. This action is called rebuilding your sketch, and it can be done by either of the following ways. Either click here or click here, or use the shortcut Ctrl plus B or Ctrl plus Q. If it's too confusing to remember all that, just pick this one. Click on here and stick to this. We are now outside of our sketching mode, and as the result, our sketch is in gray. At this point, you may go to the Features tab and pick the right tool to turn this 2D sketch into a 3D cube. Logically, the best way to turn a 2D square into a 3D is to extrude it out, and hence extruded boss base will be the tool we pick. Clicking on extrude boss, which short for extruded boss's base, our view will automatically switch from normal 2D sketch to trimetric. You can see it here. So you can grasp a better understanding of your extrusion. I can click on OK and our cube is already ready and done. But let's take a few minutes to review together what we are actually looking at. First of all, this panel is not on the Features Manager. It's on the Property Manager. And since I'm sure you missed when it was switched, I want to quickly go back and review this. Every time you pick a tool from any of these tabs or select an entity, SolidWorks automatically switches between these two, so you go to the Property Manager. This is where you get access to a control panel to manipulate or basically manage your selected tool. Now let's go back to the future. We are now looking at the Property Manager of Extruded Boss. If you wanted to extrude this 20, you could increase the value of your direction 1. What else are you looking at here? We have a flip button here that flips the direction of your extrusion. Does it matter? Yes, it does. Would you want to extrude it towards Z or minus Z? That's the difference. Also, what is direction 1? It is the direction from the plane where you drew your sketch on. In this case, our sketch was on this plane, so direction 1 is this. And logically, direction 2, should we choose to activate it, is this. Now, for someone with a tiny dose of OCD, you might want to extrude your cube 5 to direction 1 and 5 to direction 2. So your sketch would stay in the middle. But instead of making things so complicated, I could simply change the type of my direction 1 from blind to mid-plane, which is what you must do as beginners, and I cannot emphasize this enough. If you want to know why, then you should click here and go back to my channel, watch the video with more details that I told you in the previous clip. Now, let's click OK. We see that Boss Extrude 1, which is the default name SolidWorks has assigned to this feature, is recorded in the design tree on the Feature Manager. A quick recap, we chose front plane, drew a 10 by 10 square using sketch tool line, used smart dimension to assign dimensions to those lines, extruded it mid plane for 10 using extruded boss. All is left is to add a throughout hole and round its edges, as I mentioned in the beginning. And when I'm rotating it, everything looks fine. Oh wait, how am I rotating this? Navigation in SolidWorks. This is a very simple and quick guide to navigation in SolidWorks. Don't forget that this is not everything. To rotate, press and hold your middle mouse button and move your mouse. To zoom, scroll your middle mouse key up and down. Where you place your mouse cursor, you zoom there. By the way, to many people, zooming SolidWorks is reversed. When you rotate down, is reversed to many other CAD softwares out there. But you have to get used to it. If you wish to drag your part, hold Ctrl key on your keyboard, then press the middle mouse key, hold it, and now move your mouse. Just like rotating, but press and hold Ctrl on the keyboard first. To gain access to different views quick, press the space bar on your keyboard and choose a view angle you want to have. If instead of this menu you see this cube, I highly recommend you to deactivate it and learn it like pros, which is faster. Bear with me, I will reveal this at the end of this video. For pro tips and more thorough details and smoother control on your part, again, click on the info card on the top right corner and watch the video with more details. I'm telling you, everything that is not fitting into this video, you can find there for free. Okay, we are far from being finished. We have still lots of useful stuff to learn in this video, so look. All right, to add the throughout hole, I'm gonna select one of these planes over here. Let's just say front plane. Go to the sketch tab, activate the sketch. Now I'm gonna draw a circle. So logically I pick the circle tool, place my first point on the origin and draw a circle. I set the diameter 1 inches or 2.5 centimeters. So I go to smart dimension, select, click on the circle. It changes to the diameter mode, add the value, right? Now we have the sketch. We could exit it here, rebuild, go to the sketch tab. Now we want to have a negative extrude. It's called extruded cut. Every tool you see here with the name boss on it, you have the same with the name cut, which is the negative form. So I'm going to go to extruded cut, change my direction one to through all, and click OK. As easy as that. To round the edges, the tool is called fillet. Select it here. I could either select my edges one by one, or I could select the faces on my cube like this. And for these two faces that have the hole on it, I'm gonna go and select the edges. And then change the radius to, again, 1 inches or 2.5 centimeters. And click OK. So this was the objective we wanted to have to create in the beginning of the video, but we are not finished. The appearance, how to change colors, which is important, you should know. And this has a twitch in it. Bear with me. Your client just called and she said she wanted the faces on the YZ plane of your cube to be in red. And she asked you to change its color. This is how you do it. Edit appearance here for that. If you just start changing the color, the whole cube will adapt that color. So how do we only change the color of two of the faces only, the ones on the XY or parallel to the XY? For that, we must deselect the geometry that is selected on default here. Simply click on it and press delete on your keyboard, or you could right click and choose delete. Now we should select the YZ surface, which is this one. So should I just click on the surface? Let's see. Ah, no. The whole cube got selected again. Why? Because the selection type over here is set on the whole part. It means whatever pixel on this cube that I click on will select the whole thing. To only select one face, I delete my selection again and change my selection type to select faces. Now I can simply select this face and change its color to red. Now for some miraculous reasons, you just found out that this cube should have been 10 by 10 by 20, not 10. And not just randomly, the red face should stay 10 by 10 and the other faces should stretch from 10 to 20. How do we edit our component? Editing in SolidWorks. What do we know so far? We know that our sketch was 10 by 10, so let's change our extrusion length from 10 to 20. To edit the extrusion, which was our feature, by the way, we do the following. One, simple click on the box extrusion 1 here on design tree. A pop-up appears here. From this pop-up, we select edit feature. It opens the property manager again to the extrusion, and all we have to do now is to change it to 20. Boom. Wait, what? The red face had to stay 10 by 10. It seems like changing the feature was a mistake. We had to change the sketch instead. So let's move one step back by pressing Ctrl Z on the keyboard, which is the typical undo shortcut on Windows to go back being 10 by 10 by 10, we have to change the sketch. And for that, we open the combo on the feature on the design tree here. the sketch is masked under the feature. It is always like that. The plane is masked under the sketch. The sketch is masked under the feature. So when we change the lower layer, the upper layers adapt and not the other way around. Now, we see the sketch, let's edit it. One simple click on the sketch, the pop-up appears, edit sketch, and now we need to change one of these 10 to 20. Let's do this. Double click on the dimension, two rapid clicks on one of the dimensions, redefine it, type 20. Since we are still in the sketching mode, we have to rebuild again to exit it. Remember, Control B, Control Q, or just click here. Done. Project done. Now our cube changed from 10 by 10 by 10 to 10 by 10 by 20. The red face is 10 by 10. Fine. We have the throughout hole and the edges are rounded. So all that to create a cube. And believe me when I tell you, I skipped more than 90% of things you must know in order to become proficient in SolidWorks. And for that, again, I cannot emphasize this enough. I highly recommend watching the free series I have put up for you on my website that takes you from point zero all the way to the top for 1 full hour. Click on the top right corner or on the link in the description below to register free and watch it. It is the proper way of learning SolidWorks. I will cover everything you must know in the order you must learn them to not be confused and explain things that makes you unique and shows in your work. I will also explain why you need to deactivate some default settings to be more efficient, more comfortable, and faster, including the view selector cube that I mentioned earlier. We will learn how to use this same sketch to turn this cube into a pyramid or a cylinder, how to create a sphere, how to make it hollow, and all the way to the top, everything else, you name it. SolidWorks is a vast field, and wanting to learn it all at one go without knowing all these details makes it impossible if you're unwilling to put down multiple years of trial and error. Luckily, I have made it easy for you by putting all these random points in a logical sequence that makes it easy. So don't waste time. Click here now. Start watching these videos that I have put up for you until you understand everything you need to know. You will also learn how to create other geometries in SolidWorks. I'll see you there.